Hey guys, it's Savannah here, back again with another deck review. This deck right here is the Daniel Madison Steelers deck, so let's get right on in to the review. So as you guys can see by just looking at the tuck box, it is very reflective, as you can see my camera in the background. There's no writing pretty much anywhere on the deck except for the bottom. This deck is supposed to represent like brushed metal and like coming straight out of the furnace after being heated and molded into like what it's supposed to represent. And I think the tuck box accurately portrays that. However, it's really just not the most pleasing thing to look at. At the very bottom of the front, it says Steelers right here. On the side, it does not say anything, and the other side does not say anything as well. On the bottom, you get the Madison Presents logo and the Illusionist logo. And this deck is part of the Madison Presents line. And that basically is where Daniel Madison can still produce decks through Illusionist and use Illusionist's name on the decks. However, he's making and maintaining his own brand while doing so. And on the back, you get the same thing you saw on the front, except it doesn't say anything. There's no back design, no nothing. And on the flap, the design just continues as well, but the inside is white, which is a little disappointing going from this to seeing this very bright white. Before we get into the deck, this deck is a limited edition deck. Only 5,000 of these were made, and they are sold out now on Illusionist's website, so you can't purchase them off of Illusionist, so you'd have to Google or eBay or Amazon to find this deck. So let's take a look at the back design. This back design is a one-way back design. It is chain-linked, kind of like metal fence, gray, dark, and dirty kind of elements behind it. I think it accurately goes with the tuck box and kind of fits in with the overall theme. However, I just really don't like this personally as a back design. I think it just does not look very good on a back of cards, to be perfectly honest. It kind of reminds me of like a casino back, diamond shape, but I just really don't think this is designed, and I don't think it quite looks as good as some of the other decks that Madison has produced. So next we're gonna take a look at the two jokers, and I actually like these two jokers. I think they're very cool. They go along with the overall theme of the deck really well. It says the Joker on both of them in very big, bold letters, and it has that chain-linked appearance that you get on the back design within them, and on one of the jokers it has a nine of clubs reveal at the top, and the other one is just a standard joker for the deck. Next you get an Illusionist and a Madison Presents promo card, and then you get a double backer. Next we're going to check out the Ace of Spades. This Ace of Spades has the standard spade shape that all the Madison decks have. However, what's on the inside is what's different and varies from each deck that Madison produces. This deck has that same chain link appearance that you get on the back of the cards inside the spade. Pretty simple. It says Steelers at the bottom, and it says the United States Playing Card Company. Next, we're going to take a look at the court cards. We have the King, the Queen, and the Jack of Spades right here. These court cards are devoid of color. Basically, it's just a black and white design. However, there are accents of very metallic gray that pops. It's a very silver color, and it looks really good on these court cards, and I think that's a definite a win for this deck. I think that looks very good. Like in all Madison decks, some of the court cards have different faces, and they depict people in his life. The only custom court cards in this deck are the King of Diamonds and the King of Spades. The King of Spades is Jeff Lanza, his magician friend and graphic artist of many of the decks he makes, and this deck is probably no exception. And the King of Diamonds in every deck is always Daniel Madison, and that is him right there. In Daniel Madison decks, it does vary as to which court cards have custom faces. In most of his decks, almost all the court cards have custom faces, except for maybe one or two, and then in some of his decks, only two or three of the cards have custom faces, and this is one of the decks that only has two custom faces. If we take a look through the rest of the deck, everything else is standard. As I said before, I'm just not a huge fan of the overall design elements in this deck. I'm not really a big fan of the tuck box. I think it portrays accurately what the theme it was set out to portray, and I think the back design and the jokers all really add into that. However, it's just kind of disappointing going from this really like metallic to the very white on the inside. I think that has a good expectation that the inside should probably follow, and I really just don't think the brushed metal look of the tuck box, I don't think it's very pleasing to look at. However, it does portray exactly what they were going for. However, it's just really, in my opinion, not my favorite thing to look at. I don't really like the back design. It's one way, and it kind of just I mean, it fits really well with the theme they were going with, but I just personally just don't like it. However, I really do like the Jokers. I like the boldness of the words, and I think the chain length in them looks very good. All in all, from all of that I've said, I think the deck portrays the theme they were going for quite well. However, I personally just don't really like the design. Like with all Daniel Madison decks, he does not cut corners with the quality of the materials and the quality that his decks, the final product is. It doesn't degrade super easily over time. I think it's a well-handling deck. However, like I said, I just really am not a fan of the design elements. So this overall deck, I would have to give a 4 out of 5. I think the stock of this deck is really nice. It's that happy medium. It's not too thick. It's not too thin. It doesn't degrade super easily. It holds up fairly well. However, since this deck has a dark background, it does chip just a little bit on the sides. You can see the chipping on the sides. However, that comes with the territory of having a borderless deck with a dark design. So the stock of this deck, I would have to give a 4 out of 5. The look of this deck, as I said, it's just really not my favorite. I just don't think it looks that great. More specifically, the back design and the tuck box aren't really my most favorite things in the world. However, I do really like the Jokers, and I think the Ace of Spades fits in really well. Just that being said, I'm just not a big fan of this overall design. So the look of this deck, I would have to give a 3 out of 5. I think the handling and feel of this deck is very nice. This deck handles well. It looks pretty good in a fan. It overall is a good handling deck. It doesn't degrade super easily or clump after a lot of use. I think it's a very well-rounded handling deck. It doesn't really degrade over time. You can use it for quite a while, and I just really do like the way the deck handles. So the handling and feel of this deck, I would have to give a 5 out of 5. So thank you guys so much for watching my Madison Steelers deck review from Illusionist. If you guys liked this video or found it helpful or informative, please give it a thumbs up, give it a like right down below to let me know you guys found this video enjoyable or helpful. Also, be sure to subscribe down below as well to be notified when my next deck review, unboxing, or other video is live. It's 100% free. It's your only way to be notified when my deck reviews or anything else is uploaded, so I would definitely recommend doing that. Also, be sure to check out my social media, my Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff. Definitely keep up to date with me. Again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with a brand new deck review, unboxing, or other video coming your way real soon.